Lillian, I miss Lil. The first thing I think about the moment I get up is Lil. I look over on the pillow, she ain't there. I miss her all the time. Oh, Jesse. Oh, now. I wonder who's looking into her eyes, being wise, telling lies. I wonder who's buying the wine for lips that I used to call mine. I wonder if she ever tells him of me. I wonder who's kissing her now.
Single Room Occupancy, it's a photographic project that started for me in the spring of 1969 in New York City. It was my first job as a hired photographer. I was hired by the Department of Community Psychiatry at St. Luke's Hospital to work as a researcher on a project that they were then undertaking to study the populations that were living in what were then called welfare hotels or single room occupancy hotels on the Upper West Side of New York. There were probably some 80 of these hotels, and St. Luke's, together with some sociologists from Columbia University, were trying to determine the nature of the population living in these hotels, and I was asked to gather materials relating to creating a census of the people that were there. I wasn't really hired as a photographer, but since I was a photographer, I used to carry my camera around with me when I was doing the work that I was hired to do. It turned out, however, that the photographic part of my work became much more important for me, and I was able to do both things at the same time, both take pictures in the hotels of the residents, and over time, actually I was sent to live in a hotel. I lived in a hotel on West 95th Street. That was part of my job. The hotels were once elegant apartment houses, probably in the 1900s to the 1930s and 40s, and then later were divided up so that a unit that had once been the apartment for one family was divided into six rooms, and those six rooms each housed a different resident, and we all shared a common kitchen and bathroom within our unit, which once had been somebody's upscale apartment. So that was the beginning of the project.